Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. You will learn how to lift off a drone using your mind. For this project we need a drone and its controller, a soldering station and its accessories, a multimeter, the NeuroSky Mindwave Mobile, a micro USB cable, the Arduino Maker 1000, one breadboard, 4 100 microfarad capacitors, 4 220 ohms resistors, 12 jumper wires and 6 crocodile clip wires. This project should work with any drone. You can buy a cheap drone for 10 euros in an outlet store. First, we open the case of the controller. Use any force necessary, but don't break the circuit board inside. You will end up with something like this. Don't mind the wires, we add them later. Use a desoldering pump or braided copper wire to remove the tin from the PCB to disconnect the joysticks. You will end up with something like this. Actually, this joystick contains two potentiometers, one in the x-axis and one in the y-axis. We can measure the resistance of the potentiometers with a multimeter. This multimeter comes with handy clamps to attach to the potentiometer. First, we check the resistance of a potentiometer with a known resistance to make sure the multimeter is working correctly. This standard potentiometer should have 10 K resistance. When we measure the resistance of the joystick component, we see that the resistance is also 10K. This result may vary on your control. Find 4 resistors of the same value and solder them to the outer ends of each potentiometer. In this case, there are 4 10K resistors needed. Solder solid core wires to the open middle holes. Also solder the positive and negative wires. We need to convert the PWM output from the Arduino to an analog voltage. You can build a simple digital to analog converter with a low pass filter, using a capacitor and a resistor. This will be the main part of the circuit. Next, we will build a receiver that will generate the output to the controller. Grab your Arduino Maker 1000, breadboard, jumper wire, capacitors and resistors to start building the main circuit. Connect the red wire to the VCC, which gives a 3.3 volt output, and connect the ground with a black wire. This will be used as power for the controller. Make a row of polarized capacitors. The long pin goes into the ground. Use the 220 ohm resistors to connect the capacitor to the other side of the breadboard. Place the jumper wires between the resistor and the capacitor. These will give the output of the analog voltages. Lastly, connect pins 2 till 5 to the front end of the resistors. The circuit will look like this. Now is the time to connect your Arduino circuit to the Hackett controller. I use crocodile clip wires to make a non-permanent circuit. Make sure you connect the ground and VCC correctly, or you will get a short circuit. When you connected all the pins to the correct inputs on the controller, it's time to upload the Arduino sketch. There are 4 variables that control the output: throttle, yaw, pitch and roll. In the setup we start serial communication and set all the pins to output. The Arduino receives 4 8-bit values at a time, sends them with analog write to the controller. When the sketch is uploaded, you can turn on your controller and connect to the drone. Now we will look into the Mindwave sensor to control the drone. Install the drivers from CD on your laptop or PC. To activate Bluetooth pairing mode on the Mindwave sensor, you have to hold the switch for 3 seconds until the LED is flashing twice. When the Mindwave sensor is connected, put it on your head. Now we will look into the processing code. Make sure you have the Arduino connected via USB and the Mindwave sensor connected via Bluetooth. Also make sure you have the Mindset library installed in your processing libraries folder. The sketch will make a Bluetooth serial connection with the Mindwave sensor and a normal USB serial connection with the Arduino. You can find the COM ports in your device manager. The Mindset library will give you periodically an attention value between 0 and 100. This value gets mapped and will be sent to the Arduino to control the throttle of the drone. Also, there's a kill switch built in that terminates the whole program and sets the throttle to 0 in case something goes wrong while experimenting. Press K to terminate the program. run the sketch and concentrate on your drone. When you are concentrating enough, the drone will lift off. When you stop concentrating, the drone will land. The processing sketch will visualize the amount of attention needed to lift off the drone. A minimum attention level of 40 is needed to start a liftoff. I hope you have learned something today. I had great fun building this project, and I look forward to see what you will do with this knowledge. Thanks for watching.